Hello, everyone. Who we got here? Oh, we got a sub from Meldon. Thank you for that sub, Meldon. Welcome everybody. Okay, I did get the scores reset. You all have, or two of you have pretty light backgrounds, so those are kind of hard to see, actually. That's okay. How's everybody doing tonight? Welcome. We are live with Embers on the House. This is going to be episode 3. And tonight we have 3 lovely guests, competitors, and we have Guyan Gray as our first Hello. Competitor today. Which house are you representing, Gray?
I'm representing StarCamp.
StarCamp, House StarCamp. Alrighty. We have Huddy D with us. Which house are you repping today?
Brightbeam, baby.
Brightbeam. Brightbeam, best beam?
Frick yeah, dude.
And we also have Lightning with us.
What's up, guys?
And Lightning is a member of...
Fresh Beast.
Okay. Actually, to make it a little easier for people, I'm just going to change the name to have the house at the end. Buddy is BB. Mm-hmm. And Gray is SC. I guess I could put the logo there. Maybe we'll upgrade that for episode 4. All no. right. Sorry. Google, be quiet. Hey Google, stop. My Google Home is yapping at me. I don't know what it's talking about. Oh, throwing coconuts, redeeming some channel points there. So is Meldon. Get that ember. Very nice. All right. So for those of you who don't know how this game works, it is a mix of trivia, basically ripping off a couple popular trivia game shows. And then we also have a segment at the end called Debate and Pander, where we pose 3 questions for our contestants to debate and try to convince you who the winner should be. So we can jump right into it. Let me pull up our little wheel here. Nope, that's not what I want. Modify wheel. All right, so... Guy in Gray, Buddy, and Lightning. All right. So, error establishing database connection. Okay.
Wonderful.
Hey, dude. It worked this time, but Lightning only has 1 slot. Wait, no. Yeah, Lightning only has 1 slot. How did this happen? Lightning needs to be on 2 slots. And we have another error. What is going on? We'll decide. Oh, here we go. All right, everybody got 2 slots now. So we are going to spin to see who will go first. The first game we will play is... Who would like to win 7 figures before taxes? And going first will be Lightning. All right.
Let's go.
Let's do this. Question number 1. Who develops League of Legends? Do you guys have the stream up, or should I share my screen in here with you guys?
I got stream up.
I have it up.
So, is it A, Valve, B, Electronic Arts, C, Blizzard, or D, Riot Games?
Ooh, I don't know. That's a tough one. I don't know, considering I don't play the game. Just kidding, I play it. I think it's D, Riot Games.
Is it D, Riot Games? It is. Congratulations. 50 points for Lightning. Early lead. Let me add like a little background color behind the score for you, because you can't really see that.
Do it.
Just modify this real quick. Actually, we can do an outline, maybe. There we go. Now we can see it. You have 50 Beautiful. Points. All right. So, moving on. Question number two. The lamp needs counseling. What are you guys talking about?
Oh, I just have a lamp in the background on my bed.
Oh. And it's just laying there, turned off.
I need more counseling than the lamp, but it could just be me.
All right, question number two. Which console was the first to have rumble / vibration feedback on controllers? Was it the PlayStation, the Dreamcast, the Nintendo 64, or the PlayStation 2?
See, this is where my knowledge stops of video games, things related. So, I don't know. Let's see. That's a good question. I'm going to take a stab in the dark. And we'll go with the first to have rumble vibration feedback, like the controller itself, nothing added to it. Is that what you're asking?
I'm not giving any further hints on that.
Okay, I'll go with C, the Nintendo 64.
Okay, you are correct. It was the Nintendo 64. It didn't come in the controller itself. It was a separate rumble pack that went in the accessory slot there. So there you go. Well done. I'm just adding the outline to the other contestant scores here, because it will bother me. Only one person has it. You can't get special treatment, Lightning.
I mean, okay, I won't argue with that.
All right. Question number three. This is your final question for the big points.
Okay.
Big points, 150 Ember for this next one if you get it right. According to Metacritic, what is the highest rated Nintendo 3DS game? Is it Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time 3D, Shovel Knight, Pokemon Y, or Super Mario 3D Land?
Oof. I'm not a Nintendo guy, so this is really a shot in the dark here. Let's go with, I don't know, A. Zelda is always popular.
Is it A, Ocarina of Time 3D? It is. Perfect. Perfect run. Perfect run through seven figures. Well done. Perfect start for Lightning. Well played.
And thank
yes,
you. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, Ocarina of Time 3D is the highest rated game on Metacritic for the 3DS. All right, we're going to remove lightning from here. You cannot play again. Sorry. Apply these changes. We will see who goes next. Will it be Guy in Gray or Hadidu?
Hadidu.
It is Guy in Gray gets question set two here. Are you ready?
I guess I'll find out.
We will all find out right now. Question number one. Game Pass is a gaming subscription service for which family of consoles? Xbox/PC, PlayStation, Switch, or Google Stadia?
Xbox PC.
Xbox PC. You are correct. 50 points for Guy in Gray. Well done, well done.
My thank you.
PC is a family of consoles. I did a slash because you can also get Game Pass on PC. All right. Question number two. Which unopened classic game recently sold in an auction for $1.56 million? Was it A, Legend of Zelda, B, Super Mario 64, C, 1990 Nintendo World Championships Gold Edition, or D, E.T. the Extraterrestrial?
I'm going to go with B. I think it's either A or B, but I'm going to go with B.
He says B. Super Mario 64. You are correct. Okay. It is Super Mario 64. Yeah, I think it was like a week ago. There was an auction for a still sealed Super Mario 64 cartridge in its box. And yeah, makes me wish I had just never played Super Mario 64 and just saved it. But oh well.
And I sell my copy of 3D All-Stars and get the same deal.
Maybe if you sit on it for a while. have you opened it?
It's digital, so I'd have to sell the Switch with it.
You know, there for a little bit there were some phones with Flappy Bird selling for a bit. And then there was like the people with PlayStations with the PT demo that they took down from the store. I know some of those were selling for quite a bit. I don't think $1.5 million though.
Pretty cool.
All right. So moral of the story is buy games, but never open them or play them.
Good moral.
Okay, love question it. Number three, Gray. Which game holds the record for most peak viewers in an esports tournament? Is it A, League of Legends, B, PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds, C, Fortnite, or D, Garena Free Fire?
I don't know this, so I'm going to have to take a guess. A, League of Legends.
What? Turn it off!
It is a game I had not heard of until I looked it up. It is Garena Free Fire, which holds the record for most peak viewers in an esports tournament.
I'd never heard of that.
Yeah, I don't
Have either.
I don't even know what that game is, but is a lot of other people do apparently. So everyone is very confused. I'm gonna pull this up.
It's because you've showed these to me like 80 times. Okay. I've seen so many videos about
very bleak homepage.
Being dogs or being all right. Little boy.
So here's a little chart. Oh my gosh, it's so small. Let me go to the actual page. It is this, the Free Fire World Series 2021 Singapore. which peaked at 5.4 million viewers. And the game, it's a mobile game called Garena Free Fire. It's a battle royale. So I'm guessing they pumped a lot of money into this to promote their mobile whatever. But they've got the record for most viewed esports tournament.
How about you take
all right. So, 150 points for Guy and Gray.
Yet again, random not YouTube bad. People.
Okay. All right. And
who
then,
you are? You're taking personal offense.
Uh-oh.
We'll give Huddy a minute.
So that last game was a mobile game?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a mobile battle royale.
Huh.
Well, I mean, I guess Singapore has a lot of people, so I don't know.
Yeah. It's a whole different world out there.
Sorry about that.
That's all right. All right, are you ready, Huddy? Ooh, thank you for the sub.
I guess, yes.
Thank you for the sub, Talking Wolf. Welcome. Alrighty, Huddy, question number one. Who is the founder of LDS Gamers? Is it LDSG Ghost, Martin Luther Blake, Indigo Wolf, or Gabe Newell?
You know, normally I would go Gabe Newell, but I'm pretty sure it's the one and only God.
Can you spell that for me?
G-H-O-T.
Okay, we will accept that answer.
Sweet.
50 points. Congratulations. It would be cool if Gabe Newell were the founder.
I'm going to be real with you. I have no idea who that is.
He's the founder of Valve.
Because that's just its rating.
Gotcha.
All right. Question number two. The first video game character in... wow, that's not a sentence. Who was the first video game character in Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade? Was it Sonic, Mario, Tetris Blocks, or Pac-Man?
I'm gonna go with Pac-Man, I think.
Pac-Man. Was it Pac-Man? No, it was Sonic.
This is unfortunate.
It was Sonic. All right. Question number three. You still got a shot at the big points, 150 for this one. Which of the following were not special edition Nintendo 64 colors for the console? Jungle green, ice blue, Pikachu yellow, or watermelon red? So three of those were color releases in special edition consoles. One of those did not exist. Which one?
I'm going to go with jungle green.
That is not correct. It was Pikachu yellow. There were Pikachu special edition consoles, but none of them were yellow. Which is bizarre because I remember there being a yellow one, but I looked it up and there was not. But there was jungle green, ice blue, and watermelon red. So we're living in a parallel world and the Mandela effect is real.
Crazy.
Hang on. Yeah. Alrighty. So let's check in on our scores here before we move into game number two. Huddy's sitting on 50 points. Guy in Gray has 150, and Lightning has been perfect so far on 300 points. The guy who said he doesn't know video game stuff.
I guess I watch a lot of Jeopardy.
Alrighty. Cool. All right. Game number two. This game is called The Monetary Value is Accurate. And we will be... I will show three products. You all will guess the price of said product. Whoever is the closest without going over wins 100 Ember. So we will start off with Lightning. We'll go in highest score. We'll go first.
Okay.
Product number one, we have the Dyset Terra Metal from the LDSG shop.
Okay, well, I've never visited that shop. So,
looking at the picture and the quality of said dice in the dice set, how much do you think this sells for?
Let me channel my inner Bob Barker here for a second.
Please do.
Not Drew Carey. Let's think. Are we talking U.S. dollars here, to be clear?
U.S. dollary dues.
Okay. Some Washingtons. Okay, let's see. I am going to... Well, also the thing is, I don't know how much these dice are regardless, since I'm not in that realm of life. But we got to stay perfect here somehow. And let's say... $35.
$35 says Lightning. Guy in Gray, do you have a guess for me?
I'm going to go with
$19.99 for Guy in Gray. Huddy, would you like a guess?
I'm going to go a solid 50.
50 for Huddy. All right. The correct answer is $44.99. If they weren't on sale, Huddy would have won, but they are currently $10 off. So typically they are $54.99. But right now they're on sale for $44.99. Sorry, Huddy. Lightning keeps his perfect run going. 400 Ember. The dice have already decided your fate, Huddy.
Yeah, I guess I rolled a one, dude. Holy crap.
Critical fail. All right.
This is devastating.
Product number two. This is a product that I actually own. It was gifted to me in a LDSG Secret Santa.
Oh my.
That is...
Show us or it didn't have... Oh my gosh.
Oh.
It is a Nick Cage sequin pillowcase. And you can change it to give him bloody eyes. If you so choose.
Wow. Ooh. I like that.
I'm gonna make a great centerpiece.
That's a thing that exists.
It used to hang under my shelf there for a while, but that it's since been replaced by the Bling Buddy FIFA card. I need to figure out something to do with the pillowcase. The Nick Cage sequin pillowcase. Lightning. Do you have a guess for us how much you think this costs?
Wow. I mean, I might have to go buy this after the show.
There's other ones as well. If you want like a Danny DeVito sequin pillowcase, there you've got options.
But I think I should like stack these up and then make them like white elephant gifts. I think that'd be good.
Sure.
Yeah. You should only do that if I can't talk. Only do that if you're giving me one.
Okay, I'll give you one. Let's see. Let's go with $10.
$10 from Lightning. Guess? Guy in gray?
$35
for the pillowcase. Huddy, do you have a guess?
I mean, this thing is already priceless, but I'm gonna have to go 20.
20. How do you guess it's 20? And the run continues. $10.99. Lightning right on it, within a dollar of the actual.
I'm ordering
price.
It right now. I am literally going to Amazon.com.
It's quite a bargain.
That is a steal.
There's other colors as well if you want it in like a teal or black or blue for the.
Do they have purple?
Color. I don't know if they have purple. All right. I'll give you 3 pennies and some Gucci dryer lint. Well, if it's Gucci. Okay. Final product for the monetary value is accurate. We have 16 color toilet nightlight. In case your midnight pee is not RGB enough, you can now RGB your late night pee in the dark. So. Oh, I forgot to give you your points, Lightning.
What the heck, man?
RGB gaming toilet, yes.
What if I told you I actually have this?
Do you?
I do.
Oh, no. That's amazing. Okay, did you buy it or was it gifted to you?
Gifted to me by my parents.
Do you know how much it cost?
I do not.
Okay.
It must be worth a fortune, though.
The true gamer. The gaming chair you don't have to leave. All right. How much do you think the RGB toilet nightlight is?
Well, before I answer, I think where that random mobile game we talked about earlier, I think this is where people started, was on this kind of toilet.
Yep.
Because how do you get good at mobile games anywhere else? Okay, so we're going to go
$15. $15. Lightning says. Guy in gray, do you have a guess for us?
$19.99.
Huddy, do you know how?
$8.
$8. Okay. I honestly don't remember how much this costs, so we're about to find out together who won.
Live on the LDS Gamers Twitch.
It all happens live. 11.78. That means points for Huddy.
I didn't disappoint someone for once. Let's go. I'm going to go grab it for proof. Hold on.
Wait, how much did you guess?
Can he rinse that off? He guessed $8.
Dang. Wow.
Another bargain.
I'm just glad he didn't take us into his bathroom for this.
Right here.
Okay, this is it. Did you rinse that off?
We haven't used it in like a year, so it's all good.
Oh, you didn't grab it from the toilet?
No.
Okay.
Does it
light up? Is it dead?
I can go grab Oh, it doesn't even have batteries in it. Here. Would you mind if I just ran and grabbed it?
If you have batteries nearby, I think we would all love to see it.
Give me a minute.
Oh, we're getting a show tonight. I like this.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm going to get one and program it to Monster Cat music.
I should have turned on that lamp.
Metallic is requesting a song while we wait.
Oh, here we go.
See, what's even cooler about it is that it's actually motion activated. So, I
nice.
Could have sworn there's different colors. Ah, oh, there it goes.
Oh, look at that.
Wow. The strobe effect.
It's trying. I could have sworn this had different colors.
Nice.
It's not a true gamer light.
It's all good though. It still works, right? I could use that as a stream accessory.
Sorry, I just lapsed into a trance there.
You doing okay?
Yeah, I'm great. How are you?
I'm good.
Are we all just awkwardly staring?
Yeah.
Okay, did you guys think my camera froze or I froze?
I wasn't sure. I'm going to be real with you. I thought we were all just kind of like taking a little break, you know?
Yeah, taking
nap
it
time
in
kindergarten, you know?
Yeah, I get you.
For a second there, I thought the stream froze. Yeah. Good. I win. That means I win, right? Do I get points? I don't have a button to give myself points.
I'll give you points.
Okay, thank you. All right, so before we move into our final segment here, we now have a two-way tie for second place between Guy and Gray and Huddy. They're both on 150 Ember, and Lightning is killing it. Nearly perfect score so far at 500. And honestly, he's already won the episode today. It's not possible for anybody else to catch him. But we're still playing for points. These embers still matter, and we'll see if anyone can get close or claim that second place spot. So this is the first time we've gone into game 3 With the winner already decided. This is just too easy for Lightning.
Yeah, I should be disqualified.
I mean, I can take some points away.
Nah, let's keep them.
Okay. All right. So game three, this is debate and pander. The object of this game is we have three questions for our contestants. They will each give their answer and try to convince you, the audience, that their answer is the correct one. And whoever gets the most votes in our live poll will get points. And so here we go. Question number one. Actually, let me write these down. Because they sent me their answers ahead of time, and it'll be easier if I just have these written out before we jump into it.
Oh, we see your Discord on the stream.
Whoa. Oh.
Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Okay, I'm not gonna write these down. Erase that from your mind. Didn't happen. This is a highly professional game show. Okay, question number one. What is the worst superhero movie? All right. Is there anyone that would like to go first for this?
I'd be down to go first.
All right, Gray. What do you got for us?
Worst superhero movie is Batman versus Superman, Dawn of Justice. And I have got some very complex reasoning for this. Martha. That's the reasoning.
So, just to clarify, you think that Batman and Superman having mothers with the same name is not a good reason for them to decide to be friends?
Well, it's not a good reason to go from wanting to kill each other to not wanting to kill each other.
Okay. All right.
That's...
Guy in Gray has given his case. Who would like to go next?
I'll go next.
All right.
Out of the Marvel movies I've seen, Guardians 2 has got to be the worst one. Simply because there's like no important story. The really the only
good thing we got out of that. Does someone have a leak going?
So we have this thing where our ceiling got flooded, but not the upper floor and not below. So it was just filled with water, and so our roof is open. And my mic is right next to a massive pipe, so.
Okay, is everything all right?
Yeah. You can just hear water. It's all good, though.
Okay. I thought maybe someone was trying to stealthily, like, take a quick RGB bathroom break. Under the desk or something. Okay. All right.
I mean, I got the light right here, so.
Okay. So Guardians of the Galaxy 2, what didn't you like about it?
There was, like, zero story progression, and it was all just like Family Feud crap. It's like Disney animated sequels, not like Pixar animated sequels. Those are great, but like Bambi 2, there's nothing there. It's just let's go have some fun and have a minor little conflict thing. Sure, Star-Lord got to like whoa magic and stuff, but at the same time it's like, bro, what, you know?
All right. It does have Baby Groot, though.
Oh, Okay, yeah, that's Ant-Man. Honestly, the only reason I picked that one is because Gray picked Batman and Spider-Man.
Batman, Spider-Man? I want to see Batman versus Spider-Man. Actually, I don't.
I think you do.
I don't want to watch Batman murder Spider-Man.
It's just Batman versus Spider-Man in the title. They're actually working together. The single greatest crossover in movie history, I'm telling you, man.
All right. Lightning, what movie did you select?
I selected the 1997 Batman and Robin movie. For all you young kids, you probably haven't ever seen it. But it's the one where Batman and Robin have plastic nipples on their outfits. It's the one with George Clooney and Arnold Schwarzenegger. I'm listing all the bad reasons here. It's super campy. The Batman has a credit card. They have ice skates coming out of their boots. There's puns galore. I mean, the acting's horrible. I mean, if you watch it now, you'd think it's a parody movie.
It's rough.
Compared to what we have now.
It sounds like a party, honestly.
It's one of the movies that's so bad that it's good. It's very entertaining for all the wrong reasons.
Yeah, it's very theatrical and doesn't really capture anything superhero related.
Drama Club loves that movie.
So I think that's probably one of the worst superhero movies of all time.
All right.
I might need to watch that later, man.
It's a good one. It's a good watch as far as good, bad movies go. Batman Forever is another good, bad movie.
One where there's a dance party?
That one's basically a Christmas movie.
Yeah, I was torn between that one and Batman and Robin.
All right. Cool. So I am going to start a poll here, and you should get a little button at the top of chat once I set this poll live that you can click on, and you will be able to vote on who you think should win. So we're going to start a new poll here. Worst superhero movie. Batman and Robin, Batman versus Superman, Dawn. We'll just do Batman versus Superman.
Dawn.
Guardians of the Galaxy. Dose. All right, and we are going to give you guys 2 minutes to vote. Alrighty. So, we'll keep an eye on the results here. Click at the top of chat, and you can vote if you have channel points and would like to use those to get extra votes, or if you have some bits and want to use those to get extra votes, you can do that also.
I got banned in chat for saying crap.
Nightbot didn't like that. That's really funny because the comment got held by Twitch from posting, and then when I allowed the chat to go through, Nightbot then timed you out for 5 seconds. For cursing. So yeah, use carp, I guess.
Yeah. We'll make sure to use the fish.
We gotta really close race between the two Batmans. People do not think Guardians of the Galaxy 2 is the worst superhero movie.
I don't either. I just ran out of options.
I just want everybody to just go look up the Batman and Robin Batman outfit, and then you'll know why.
But Mark,
I'm looking it up.
We got a one vote lead for Batman and Robin.
Come on, there can't only be like 5 or 6 Star Campers watching this.
All right. Batman and Robin wins it. Lightning continues to just bowl through everybody, taking all the points. Up to 600 now for Lightning. All right. Well done. Well played. Pay to win. Guy in gray tried to pay to win.
Yeah. Like 5 of those votes were for me. Didn't work out.
That's funny. Yeah, did not. Alrighty. Moving on to question number 2. Describe a video game that you wish existed but doesn't. And I just included a weird gamer bed picture because it's weird.
I'd buy. No, I wouldn't.
Yeah, it seems really uncomfortable to just sit in bed like that.
There's no back support.
Yeah.
I don't know. Then again, it would help me kind of get over my social issues by completely removing them.
I do like this little phone holder thing over your head. That would be kind of cool to get something like that.
I would get overused by me. Anyway, one night it would just drop on my head.
Who would like to go first in describing the video game they wish existed but does not? Any takers?
I'll go.
We can bring back the wheel.
Nah, I'll go.
All right, Huddy. What you got?
Okay, so I know we all hate mobile gaming, right? But yeah, exactly. But
I'm singing for
but like, can you imagine the game kind of Pokemon Go style? Or I guess it could just link up with like a desktop game too, but where you had to bring your phone with you and you had to go meet up with people real life at like different locations around your area to go like do puzzles, solve challenges, beat bosses together. But then like if you went out and did it together, you would advance more and be able to do more things so that you're not just sitting at home constantly. So kind of Pokemon Go, but at the same time, it's like not.
All right, I'm just going to put not Pokemon Go. For the title.
I feel like this is going against me, but okay, that works.
Do you have a better title for me to use for this? I need something to put in the poll.
Almost Pokemon Go.
Almost, okay. All right, cool. Gray, do you want to tell us about your game?
Sure. So, imagine the creative and engineering aspect of Space Engineers, the live universe aspect of Elite Dangerous, the actually really, really good-looking visual of Star Citizen, and the life and procedural planet generation of No Man's Sky. Put that all together to create the ultimate space game. And I actually...
That would be really... For it. So, mm-hmm. You're taking two video games whose scopes were way too big for them to complete on their own, adding in two more games and making that a video game. Is that right?
Pretty much, yeah.
All right. Awesome.
So, hey, if we're dreaming, we're dreaming big here.
Let's go ultimate space game.
And I even got a name for it that I thought of. Void of the Aurora.
Void of the Aurora. You've definitely put more thought into yours than Huddy. No offense, Huddy.
Well, with a life goal of wanting to be a gamer. I'm
crying myself to sleep.
Hey, you're...
I mean, I do that every night as it is, but, like, it'll be more tonight.
Extra wet pillow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, if you ever actually make that game, Huddy, I'll play it.
Yeah, we'll do some LDSG meetups for almost Pokemon Go. All right. Awesome. Lightning, what you got?
All right. So we're going in the realm of Star Wars here.
Okay.
And there's been no video game that I'm aware of, unless it's some random game, that it's solely focuses on Darth Vader and what happened, like, episode 3 and on. You know, like, I think it would be cool to have a game where you're just solely Darth Vader. He's not just some random playable character. Or a side character, but that's the main character, and you just go through just like post episode 3, like what happened to him and what he went through and just like what Palpatine made him go do, and you know, all these things to like how, you know, Vader helped form the Empire. So I think that'd be a pretty cool game, and you get to be Darth Vader and just wreck everybody without trying. So, you know, I think that'd be fun.
Nice. Darth Vader game.
Not just the Force Unleashed with just Darth Vader. No, I'm like, you go deeper into Darth Vader's storyline.
Yeah.
There is actually a lot of the expanded universe comics and such that go into that sort of stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. That would be cool. That would be cool. I don't think I showed anyone's address in Discord messages. You just might have seen some chats about answers for tonight. Cool.
I mean, I think they're asking for some doxing action, so again, let me just paste my address in chat.
No.
Oh.
Please don't.
Why not? It'd be funny.
It'd be a quick way to get banned from
I'd chat. Get severed toes on my front door, though, man. It'd
yeah,
be sick.
That's you would be sick.
Isn't Naughty Chat banned, though?
All right. No, he got timed out for 5 seconds. He should not be banned anymore. All right, so I'm going to open our new poll here. All right, so new video game. All right, Darth Vader game. Void of the Aurora, which is Guy and Gray's space game. Or almost Pokemon Go. All right, here we go. Poll should be at the top of chat. Get in there, get your votes in. We got an early vote for Void of the Aurora. Ooh.
Three-way tie, ooh. Look at that.
Darth Vader game. 2 votes. Three votes. So, Bison is saying he zoned out during Guy's explanation, but didn't like Lightning or Huddies, so he voted for you.
Well, thank you.
What game names did he say? Coconut? Darth Vader Goes to Counseling. I saw that one.
Yeah, that was the one I saw, and that's fire, honestly. Yeah. I'd play that.
I don't think that's what happened, though, based on what followed. Okay, we got a tie between Vader game and Void of the Aurora.
Come on, Brightbeam, don't you want some embers?
Come on, Fresh Beast, don't you want to dominate even more?
Oh, you got a vote, Huddy.
Let's go.
This game is called Debate and Pander.
Who doesn't want to get panned?
Hey, we're tied.
Huddy's really bad at the debate part, but he's good at the pandering part, I guess.
This is true. This is very true.
Oh, we have a tie.
Oh.
All right, vote off.
I'm literally going to start gifting subs.
I'm just going to give 100 to each.
All right, I'm good with that.
For Huddy and Lightning. And I'm going to give 50 to Gray because that was really close.
Honestly, I like Gray's best.
Yeah. If it accomplished what he wants it to accomplish, it would be insane.
Yes. Like, I don't like space games, but it would be freaking sick.
Yeah. All right. Last question. And Lightning has locked this up for a while, but chance to get to 800. What is the best ever game console? What's the best game console ever made? Any takers for first dibs here? I don't think Lightning's gone first. Lightning, do you want to go?
Okay. All right, I'll go first. Best ever game console. Let's go with the graphing calculator. Let's go with
the TI-84.
Yeah, that's what I used. Let's go with the Xbox 360.
The 360.
Yes. It birthed. I know, like, Xbox Live was a thing with, like, the first Xbox, but people didn't really have it. But 360 is when it was really a thing, and it birthed amazing Xbox 360 lobbies, which are still talked about to this day. I made some friends through them. I think it was pretty cool. Also, it had, you know, Halo, and Halo is one of the greatest games ever, in my opinion. So, but I think the Xbox 360 really brought in the social aspect of gaming and really made it mainstream. The PlayStation 2 and 3, I guess, didn't. There was that, but I mean, you didn't think of, like, you know, the PlayStation version of Xbox Live is, but like, you knew what Xbox Live was, and you knew, hey, I gotta get an Xbox and play with my friends. So I think that's probably one of the greatest consoles because it really pushed the whole social aspect forward.
All right, Xbox 360. Nice. Okay, Huddy, Gray, either of you want to jump on next?
I'll go next.
All right, Gray, what you got?
I've got PC. No, it's PC is a game console, because while it is other things, it is also a game console. This is one of its qualities. And I think it's the best because of the sheer variety that you can get with a PC that you don't get anywhere else. You've got everything on Steam, everything on Epic. You've got, you know, Flash games in a browser. You've got so much you can play. I think that's why it's best.
Yeah. And just wait for PC 2. When PC 2 comes out.
Oh, yeah.
Man, I've heard some crazy things about PC 2. All right, so PC for Guy in Gray. Huddy, what do you believe is the best game console?
I got a lot of my generation in chat, which means that we have all owned this console at one point or another, and that is the Wii. The Wii is the single greatest console ever made. Okay, that thing had Wii Sports Resort. That thing is honestly top 10 games of all time for me. It's got Wii Bowling, it's got all the Wii Sports stuff, it's got Mario Galaxy, also one of my top 10s. It's just, it's an overall fun console, and I honestly, I need to get one, just because I freaking love that one, dude. The Wii is just, good stuff. One of Nintendo's greatest.
Very nice. All right. We are going to open up the vote here for the last points of the episode. New poll. Best game console. All right.
Hey, Minecraft came out on PC first as well, so there's that.
Stop cheating.
He's not cheating. you can keep talking. I'm not muting anybody.
Well, people don't want to give me more points. That is rude.
I had a 360 as a kid, but I played the Wii a lot more.
Yeah. I feel like the Wii was more LDS family friendly than a 360.
I still play Halo.
Probably a lot of the games from the 360 or the Wii were developed on a PC, so that's that.
I tried to pick Wii, but Huddy picked it before me because he knew how to win this question. So congrats, Huddy.
There are some bangers. Wii is also the birth of one of the greatest villains of all time in video game history, Matt from Wii Boxing. That guy was an absolute monster and just like Satan with boxing gloves.
He was the Mike Tyson of the Wii.
Exactly.
I have his autograph. Cool guy. He also punched me in the face repeatedly, so that's not cool, but whatever.
All right. It's running out of time for PC to catch up. We got a 2-vote lead for Wii. Time's ticking.
Time to pull out your wallets, everyone. Vote for the 360. Use those bits.
All right. The Wii gets the win. 100 Ember to Huddy. But our big winner for tonight is Lightning putting on a clinic. Well played to Lightning.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, 700 Ember for Lightning. Very well done. We also saw 350 go to Huddy and 200 for Guy in Gray. Thank you so much for our contestants. Any parting words for us, Lightning, as
go
our as our
Twitch
champion? No. You don't get a plug. You didn't win.
Dang it, man!
Everyone, go unfollow Huddy on Twitch.
All right, done. Last words. I was just I just came here to hit dingers and have a good time. And that's exactly what I did.
I'm just doxing Mello right now. Accidentally. I'm sorry, Lightning. You're here to what?
Hit dingers and have a good time. Oh, so
yes,
that is exactly what I did. And I made Fresh Beast proud.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. Thank you for playing. And thank you, Huddy and Gray, for playing as well. Thank you for another fun episode of Embers on the House. We will be back next month, toward the end of the month, back to our more normal time. So we didn't have a new episode last month due to some scheduling conflicts, but we'll be getting back on our normal schedule with an episode on the last Thursday of each month. So if you would like to participate and play, it's possible I might dox your Discord DMs. So keep that in mind if you message me. But aside from that, reach out to your House Ember Guardian and let them know that you would like to play. And we'll get you on the list to come on a episode in the future. So thanks for playing, guys. Everyone have a great night. Let's see, is there anyone on the team who we can raid?
Here, let me go live really fast. No, I'm
You are trying really hard.
I know I am, and I'm gonna stop now.
All right, Alex Mann is on our Twitch team and he's streaming, so let's give Alex Mann a raid. All right. So when we get in there, everyone tell Alex Mann you're here with the raid, and have a great night. And yeah, we'll be back with some more streams in the coming weeks. We've got some fun stuff coming up, and then yeah, a new episode of this next month. Thanks. Bye, everybody.
Good night.
See ya.